long time ago, on a very peculiar day, my mirror lured someone out of his bed and opened a doorway to my workshop. I do not know if the mirror was being mischievous or malicious. Perhaps it knew that the curious intruder had a role to play in my project. I was putting the finishing touches on my latest creation. A world for things that have been forgotten. Satisfied with my progress, I put the magic brush down and retired to my chambers. Had I known what events would follow, I would have locked away everything. Paint, brush, and thinner. See what had happened, but I was too late. The world I had created was ravaged, a wasteland. The mysterious intruder was gone. I did not learn his identity. Well, not for a very long time.
Years ago, Disney said, let's take Mickey Mouse, but make it edgy. And that's what we're playing today. Hey everybody, welcome to Epic Mickey, here on Quick Play, the series where we take a look at the first 20 or so minutes of a game to see if it entices me to continue playing. We're already like 5 minutes into this video, so let's get going, shall we? I think Mickey's dead. I think that's kind of what happened there at the beginning. What do we got here in extra? Okay. I don't like the frame rate of the pointer, I'll say that much. That's, Okay, this is literally just... That's just saved games. Okay. Don't know why that menu didn't just say saved games instead of extras, but alright, let's jump on in. to Epic Mickey. And here's save games again. Okay, new game, let's go. Unless I accidentally clicked on... Maybe I clicked on this before. I don't know, let's go. See, that's a cool picture. I like that. But, don't really know how to feel about the game yet. I have heard mixed things. Mickey doesn't mess around, apparently. Like, there was nothing there, like, to help him out. He just ripped his arm free. Okay. Get over here, you bucket of bolts! Miss me! Well, thanks, Gus. I don't know who you are, but thank you. Over here, Mickey! Where? Right there. We're fighting a giant... what the heck is that thing called? The knife thing? What is that called? Why can I not remember what that's called? Anyway. Quest added, escape Dark Beauty Castle. Dark Beauty Castle. Okay, then. Now, those of you who have been around on my channel for a while, you may know that I have actually covered the second Epic Mickey game before. I did the demo. Oh. And I also did one of the 3DS ones, I think? But it's been literal years. It's been a very long time. We're safe in this spot, Mickey. This control panel can be damaged with your spin move. Use your spin move by shaking the Wii remote. All right. Bye. Bye then. Okay, yeah, you keep the thingy distracted. That'd be great. What is that knife called with the multiple different things? The control panel is broken. Come take care of this one. All right. Let me just, one more spin move. Is that good? It's a Swiss Army knife, I just remembered. Quickly press A for a short jump, do a longer jump, open chest. Alright, let's go. Typical 3D platformer stuff, let's go. Double jump. Of course. I wonder if, like, the beginning of this game, was it supposed to be a reference to the GameCube game? With the magical mirror? Or was that not a thing? I have distinct memories of a magical mirror starring Mickey Mouse for a Nintendo GameCube. Because, my dad played it, and I think my dad traded it in for Luigi's Mansion. Or the other way around, something like that. I just distinctly remember my dad playing it a lot when I was a kid. Break this control panel! I'm working on it! Look, the mechanical arms destruction revealed a secret room. You may take a moment to explore it if you'd like. I'd love to. But you want me to go over there. When you're ready, come to me and we'll get out of here. Okay, I would definitely like to go explore the secret room, please. Was it down here? Is that what this is? I guess so. Ooh, it's me! Extra content unlocked. The Mad Doctor's Lab Number 2. Not quite sure what that is, but okay, sure. I don't know if I'd celebrate that hard over a bronze pin. Well done! This is a collectible pin, one of many that you may find in Wasteland. Most of them are unique and commemorate specific events or places. You should see how many you can collect while you're here. Okay, also, Donald? Not Donald? Alright, what was that? Definitely just saw something like in my camera. What the heck was that? Or maybe I'm just seeing things. It's quite possible. Alright, I guess let's head on back up there. Do we have anything else we can do right now except spin and jump? I think that is literally all we can do at the moment. Wait, what's up here? I see you shining. I see you. I can break the things. What are these things that we're collecting? Little tokens? Tickets or something? I would like to break in there, please. Also, wait, that's me, isn't it? No, that's Oswald. Never mind. I don't know much about Oswald. I know he's like a forgotten Disney character. Or at least he was until they brought him back in this. Okay, get the thing, Mick. Okay, is that health? I'm guessing that's health, and we're fully healed right now. Okay. Well, that's fine. Again, I think it was a lot of health. How much damage you expecting me to take here? I'm not sure if we can even get hit by the Swiss Army knife. I had to rack my brain for the name of it again there. Alright, Gus. Where are we going? Are they just using stock Mickey sounds? They didn't actually get him so that they could voice Mickey? Who voices Mickey? Who the heck voices Mickey? That's something I've just never known. Press or hold the Z button to use thinner, press or hold the B button to use paint. The end of this corridor is the courtyard. It will take us out of Dark Beauty Castle. Don't worry, I will always be around when you need help, even though you may not always see me. Alright, so fill that in. I will openly admit the pointer is a little bit jerky. I can give it that. It's kind of going all over the place. What is that? Oh, I guess we have to collect paint and thinner in order to keep using it. That makes sense. Yeah, the pointer's a little bit all over the place. I am playing rather far away from the TV, but still. Point at the thin gear, then press and hold the B button to paint it. I will do my best. Yeah. Gotta do this wall too. There we go. Alright, I definitely remember the paint mechanics from when I played the second game. It's kinda like the main deal here. This is what Epic Mickey's all about. It's unusual, I'll give it that. Your brush can also thin out cartoon objects like that door frame. Point at the frame with the Wii remote and hold down the Z button to hit it with thinner. I'm trying, it's kinda not working. Be careful of that thinner pool. Remember that it can hurt you, so don't fall in. Yeah, I wasn't planning on it. Definitely was not planning on it. Okay, did I just do like a big splash? Oh, wait a minute. I did like a big splash of paint. Some of this is feels familiar. The janky Wii remote controls don't feel familiar. But some of this definitely feels like I've done it before. Did I do a video on the first game and I just didn't never realize. I did search on my channel and didn't see the first game. It looks like you can use thinner on the toon floor to clear the way. I can certainly try, as soon as my Wii Remote decides it wants to work properly. Don't forget that the thin toon can be restored with paint. Like so. Beautiful, beautiful. Hello? What's going on in here? The exit is through that gate, or this gate. Alright, cool. And that is a poop monster. A poop eyeball. Alright.
Oh!
Yeah.
I'll admit I like the cutscene art style. I think that's super cute. Alright, so you want me to turn this boy friendly, eh? Look out! The seer saw you, Mickey! Are they not supposed to? Looks like it's called it a friend. I made it friendly, did I not? There we go. Now you also be friendly, please. And then I'm gonna bonk you. Or no, I'm not. Wait. Can I not hit him while they're friend- Oh. Get out of here! Can I not kill you while you're friendly? Hold on, let me make you evil again. Come here! Get back here! Why are you running? Come here. Yeah. Can we not kill these guys? Are they just invincible? Alright, fine. Just be friendly then. I don't care. Just we can be friends. I don't think he's friendly now, is he? He was definitely making an evil alarm sound. I'll take that. Listen, bud. Just be blue. Be more blue. There you go. Now, goodbye. I'm gonna just leave you guys alone now. Just gonna leave you to do your thing. As you were. Use your spin move on this gear to interact with it. Remember that you can spin by shaking the Wii Remote. I definitely did not forget that already. Again? Okay. Again! Oh, I thought that was him. That's Gremlin Calvin. He'll be so happy to get out of that cage. He looks mad enough to break that catapult. Careful, Mickey. That chest is sitting on a pressure plate that will fire this catapult if it's disturbed. Do you really want to choose some e-tickets over the safety of a gremlin? kinda. When you see other gremlins, try to help them. They're sure to be friends.
I kinda wanna do it.
Careful, Mickey. I know. I know what it's doing. Yeah. Uh-oh. Bye! Mickey, you just launched Gremlin Calvin to who knows where for a treasure chest? That isn't something a hero would do. Are you one? A hero, that is? I'm a mouse. That's all you need to know. Anyway. Can we walk up here? Yes, we can. Can we thin this out? Yes, we can. Thinner can remove these toon blocks. Need to hit something with thinner? Just quickly press the Z button. Quickly get Wii Remote, please. God, this is aggravating. Oh, I guess I can also do that with paint, huh? Mickey, these are the guardians. They are the primeval spirits of Wasteland. Because of your unique nature, they are drawn to you. The blue ones, tints, will befriend those who would otherwise harm you. Okay. Meaning... I'm confused. My pointer's just not moving now. It's just bouncing all over the place. Okay, can we... There we go. Does my paint and thinner, like, gradually restore over time? It looks like it does. You can quickly press the C button to center the camera in front of you. That is behind me, sir, but okay. Whatever you say. Oh my god. Pointer, please. I could not be pointing anymore at the TV right now. Wait, give me the paint. And then paint it. Oh god, Mickey, it's going all over the place. You're getting your paint everywhere. Use your spin move on this gear. I'll try. You don't have to keep reminding me how to spin. Alright. You lock that gear. You knock that gear loose. See the gate opening? One more gear will do it. Here in Wasteland, you'll find that gears and machines make all kinds of things happen. Repairing and starting them will often reveal secrets and treasures. Will it reveal the secret of how to make my Wii Remote work correctly? Because that's the only secret I'm looking for right now, if I'm being honest. These are green guardians, the Terps, will damage your enemies on contact. Your actions in this world will determine what kind of blah 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 blah. Okay. Paint. Pointer. Paint. Paint. So, how do I, like, use those? Or are they just kind of there? I guess they're just kind of there, huh? Does this not work? Do I just... Am I actually platforming? I'm not platforming. Hold on. Camera. Am I supposed to... Okay. I feel like I wasn't supposed to do that. I don't know why. I just have a feeling that that was not what the game wanted me to do. But here we go. Okay, that works for me. Here's the gear. Okay, so you don't have to tell me how to spin for the 50th time. Second gear down and a projector screen. That's our way out of the castle. Let's take a closer look. Gladly, where is it? Is it this way? Wah! Oh god, Mickey just... Did that actually do fall damage? That does do fall damage. Okay. Let's get the heck out of here. Mickey and the Beanstalk. Oh? 2D platformer where I don't have to point at the screen? I'm down for that. I'm definitely down for that. Give me all the stuff. Okay, so the TV screens, or the projector screens, are little 2D minigame sections that I guess also act as like a loading thing? Maybe? Okay, give me this. Get over there. Okay, this is kind of cool. This is honestly the coolest part of the game so far. You got the little film reel at the side. I really like this. Ooh, give me that. I don't know what it is, but new film reel received, Mickey and the Beanstalk. Does that mean that I can, like, play this again, or did I unlock the actual video, Mickey and the Beanstalk? Is that what you're telling me? I should not have jumped over here. Damn it. Come on, Mick. Get back up there. And okay. Can we use our... No, we can't use our paintbrush in here. This is so weird. This does bring back memories of, like... Isn't there a... There's a Mickey Mouse game on the... It's either the NES or the Super Nintendo. Oh god, what is this? Oh, is that like a That's All, Folks? No, that's Looney Tunes. That is Looney Tunes. This is just like the end of episode face. I would like to travel to Slalom. Let's go. I don't like the snot coming off of Mickey. That's just gross. Like how it floats up towards the sky. No, thank you. No, thank you indeed. Okay. We're somewhere. You know, you could just fly over here, dude. Hey, it's Gremlin Tisto. What are you doing, Tisto? Okay.
All right, Gus. Someone sabotaged this door. It's gonna take paint to fix it.
Well, you're in luck. I happen to have that. That's an impressive door. Definitely Gremlin construction. Hey, Mickey. You can throw paint around. Why not paint those gears for Tisto? Tisto? That'd be great. I've been working on that middle gear, so don't break it, please. What if I do? What if I just walk up to it and I just go... You broke that door! That wasn't very nice. Does this game have a good, like a good and evil system? Is that what I'm learning here? You can be good Mickey or evil Mickey? Thin out, letting steam stay, escape. Okay. Like, what are the consequences for doing evil things? I wanted to get it working again, not ruin it. Thought your blood like drips were just for show. Yeah, I'm not so sure. Let's go on your way. I'll see you farther along the passage as I make my repairs. I would say I'm sorry, but what the heck? That's so odd. Like, if you don't want me to break the door, don't tell me that I'm able to break the door. You know? Simple as that. Let me get my, bit more paint, I guess. There was a whole lot of crap in there. Okay. There it is again. We should be able to go that way, too. But watch your step. Let's see. Oh, we definitely do need to heal now. Can we just paint this whole thing? Yeah. We can just paint the whole thing. Let me grab the little corner piece. There we go. Where's this dude? Painter thinner should get you through here. That big gear, blah, 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 blah. Okay. I think I've got the... Yep. One to see the world. Okay. First person, Mick. All right. Finally know what my camera controls are. Okay. I think I've got the gist. I'm going to be totally honest with you. The lack of decent Wii Remote pointer... Look at this. What is he pointing at? The lack of decent pointer control is making me not want to continue playing this, if I'm being honest with you. Maybe that's a stupid thing to not want to continue playing a game for, but I'm trying to move it all over the place right now, and it is not having it. I do sort of remember from when I played the second game that I had similar issues, I think. Tracing a double jump. I know how a double jump works. What platform? That platform. Okay. I remember, or seem to remember, having similar issues when I played the second game for Let's Demo many, many years ago. And it seems like the first game had the exact same problems, so... And another evil door. Okay. Is this a trap? Probably. Quite possibly. It is a trap! Oh no, a guy! You seem super easy to be friends with. I guess. There's like no challenge to these enemies. At least that's not what I'm... At least that's what I'm kind of noticing here. Did that work? That did work. And now he fights for me, I guess. But then we make him friend. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm going to go ahead and call it an episode here, folks. I'm literally pointing at the screen and moving the Wii Remote around right now, but the pointer's just staying there. Oh, there we go. And this isn't just like the position that I'm holding the remote in comparison to the TV. Like, I played Mario Galaxy in this setup and it works just fine. So I think I'm going to call it an episode there. Definitely let me know your thoughts on Epic Mickey in the comments below. I don't believe it was released on anything other than Wii. It might have been. And if it was, it probably had better controls. But yeah. I'm gonna call it there. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like. And of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.